In the Parliamentary Committee of Education, members of Parliament have put the Minister of Education officials on the task to explain steps being taken to curb exorbitant fees in government-grant-aided schools. However, this sparked mixed reactions from members of Parliament.
You need to explain to this committee what you have done on charges of exorbitant fees. And lastly, the issue of your government schools, they are all charging fees. And I have the details.
There is no way the minister who is here can run away from the issue of exorbitant fees costs of Uganda to the Ugandans when this issue has been a very important issue on the floor of parliament for almost 2 weeks. I don't know why, Chair, you have guided that the minister should bring this in writing. Ugandans should know now because children and pupils and students are going back to school.
Mr. Chairperson, I want to request that we consider government withdrawing support to these schools 100%. Secondly, we are burying our head on sand, trying to deceive the voters that we can regulate fees. What government needs to do to support government school to be high quality, the public then will move away from private school.
The State Minister for Higher Education, John Chrysostom Muyingo, reiterated government's commitment to harmonize the issue of skyrocketing school fees.
We had submitted a proposal to cabinet before last year. Then government advised us that instead of the instrument, that government was going to look for money to pay for universal and compulsory primary education, universal and compulsory secondary education.
Committee members also quizzed the education minister officials over delays to roll out a revised curriculum of A level.
I'm a member of budget committee. There is no money for A level curriculum in the budget. The minister did not put money on for the A level curriculum.
Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.